police say the stories don't match up after talking to both sides about an altercation between Preston Knowles and his girlfriend's stepfather. Knowles is under investigation for assault, and Aaron Haynes joins us now with the very latest details. Aaron.
Carissa, Bullitt County authorities had hoped to have this investigation wrapped up by the end of this week, but with inconsistent stories, they say there are several more people they need to talk to.
If we believe that there's enough evidence here to warrant that he should be charged, he'll be charged. If it's not, he won't be.
That question remains to be answered for U of L senior guard Preston Knowles after his girlfriend's stepfather accused Knowles of assaulting him Sunday night at their Shepherdsville home. U of L assistant coach Steve Masiello spoke exclusively to WLKY about Knowles and these allegations.
He's been a great young man. He's been an example. He's a tremendous worker, very intense young man who plays hard, brings it every day. Unfortunately, this is something that we're going to have to look into, and we'll see how it plays out.
Bullitt County authorities say an argument between Knowles and his girlfriend started over a hairbrush. As it escalated, the girl's stepfather intervened, and blows were exchanged. These photos sent to WLKY show the injuries to the man's face. Knowles claims it was self-defense. In a statement released today, an attorney for the man's family says the family tells a very different side than some of the reports already shared with the media. Bullitt County Detective Scotty McGahey says over the past 2 days, he has interviewed those directly involved on both sides.
There are some things in the parties that have spoken with us right now without getting into detail that are consistent, but there are some parts that are not consistent. So that's what we will try to determine, hopefully, by the time we finish this.
McGahey says there were about a dozen people at the home Sunday night and hopes getting statements from those not directly involved will help determine exactly what happened.
But hopefully we'll be able to go through the statements and through the interviews and that, be able to tell the truths and separate that from the things that are inconsistent.
Detective McGahey says depending on the availability of the remaining witnesses, he hopes to have this investigation finished sometime next week. I'm Aaron Haynes, WLKY News.
Thank you.